today. Rain. Keeping warm? Keeping out of trouble? No. Okay, we're going to do the, pardon?
Did you tell them we changed it?
No, I hadn't. I was going to, but do
go
you want to?
Go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
you first.
You go ahead.
Well, as you can see in your order of service, Unwritten is going to be the first song, but it's not. We've changed it to the second song. I know it's not going to really make a difference to you, but anyway, I thought I'd let you know. This one's called I Saw God. This is kind of for Reverend Annette. She loves this song, and we love her, so.
You know, people are looking for God all over the place, but I think we're supposed to see God in each other. One, two. I saw God the other day. He looked like you.
Like me?
A pretty girl.
Wow.
I saw God the other day.
Looked just like you.
An old hippie?
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna tell you a story, and this one you can repeat. I saw God the other day, don't you know it? Just walking down the street. And she said,
I have something I want to tell you. Something that I really want to say. You've been waiting for my return, but the truth is, I never went away.
I don't care if you believe me at all. I know who I saw.
Who did you see?
I saw God. I don't care if you believe me at all. No, I don't, because I know who I saw.
Who was it, Richard?
It was God. I said, hold on a minute now. How do I know it's really you? And she gave me a simple answer. She said,
you don't. Unless you do.
Ah, wait a minute now. I don't quite understand all of this. Tell me, what do you want with me? You see, I'm not a religious type of person. And she said,
you don't have to be.
Well, I don't know if I'm the right person for you to talk to. You know, I got a few puzzle pieces missing. And she said,
I speak to everyone, but not everyone chooses to listen.
Well then, tell me, how should I treat my enemies? You know, those people I despise. And she said,
the answer will be clear when you see me in their eyes.
I don't care if you believe me at all. No, I don't, because I know who I saw.
Who was it, Richard?
It was God.
I don't care if you believe me at all.
I know who I saw. It was God. Now I spoke that God that day, and she'll speak to you too. And she told me that
of all the miracles ever created, the grandest one is you.
Now that you've told me all of this, can you tell me, what am I supposed to do now? And she said,
you may think it's up to me, but really, it's up to you.
Well, now my eyes are open, and I can clearly see all the things I paid for in this life, you know, I could have had for free. And she said, I'm going to share with you now her parting words. And you might want to listen carefully to what she said.
If I only have one son, then tell me, who are you?
I don't care if you believe me at all. No, I don't, because I know who I saw.
Who did you see?
I saw God. I don't care if you believe me at all. I know who I saw.
Yeah? It was God.
I saw God the other day. She looked like you.
Like me, wow.
Yeah, pretty girl.
I saw God the other day. Yeah. Looked just like you.
Had overalls on.
Yeah.
Long hair. Oh, how about that?
I saw God the other day. I saw God the other day.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I saw God the other day.
I see God. Amen. Thank you.
I want to welcome everyone and thank everyone joining us on social media today here at the Temple of the Living God in St. Petersburg, Florida. Please click on the donate button at the top of our page to help support our mission. We greatly appreciate all donations. Thank you so much. Today we have Reverend Carmen Lucis speaking on A Fresh Start. I have chosen a passage by Marianne Williamson from A Return to Love. Many of you may be familiar with this. It's one of my all-time favorites. It's powerful. I invite you to close your eyes, if it's comfortable, to hear every word that I'm going to say. Our Deepest Fear, by Marianne Williamson. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, to be gorgeous, talented, fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. There's nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine, as children do. We were born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. It is not just for some, it is for everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we're liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. End of quote. Shine on. And now, Carol and the Goodfellas.
A while back, did you want to say anything about it?
When I was a younger hippie, there was a poster that said, today is the first day of the rest of your life. And Carmen's talk, A Fresh Start.
Ready? Yes.
Something in the distance, so close you could almost taste it. Release your inhibitions, feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else can speak the words on your lips. Trench yourself in words unspoken, live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins, rest is still unwritten.
Some
sometimes my tries are outside the lines. We've been conditioned to not make mistakes, but I can't live that way.
Staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window. Let the sun illuminate the words that you cannot find. Reaching for something in the distance, so close you can almost taste it. Release your inhibitions, feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else can speak the words on your lips. Drench yourself in words unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten. Staring at the blank page before you, open up the dirty window. Let the sun illuminate the words that you cannot find. Reaching for something in the distance, so close you can almost taste it. Release your inhibitions, feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you, only you can let it in. No one else can speak the words on your lips. Stretch yourself in words unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins.
Brain on your skin.
And no one else can feel it for you. Only you can let it in. No one else can speak the words on your lips. Stretch yourself in words unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten.
Yeah. Fresh start.
Yes.
There's a story about a woman who found a folded, hardened sponge. And as she held that, she felt as though there was some sort of a message within this sponge. So she had the inspiration to go down to the sea, and she walked into the water about waist deep, and she put that hardened sponge into the water, and she saw it begin to unfold. And to her amazement, there were bubbles coming out of it, and then there was this tiny fish that had been asleep for who knows how long, woke up, and swam out into the water, into the ocean. And she was just so in awe and so full of joy and peace in having that experience. And she remembered every single day after that, that here was this tiny fish that awoke and just swam freely out there in the water. And she took that with her every day. A powerful, powerful time in those moments. And whatever path that we're journeying on, whatever experiences that we have to go through, the secret of life somehow always has to do with awakening and freeing that which has been asleep. Each time we free ourselves, just like the little fish, our soul is set free, which in turn brings us a sense of peace and joy. It's interesting that when we make a fresh start, when we move into new territory, explore new possibilities, when we embrace a higher version of ourselves and we put our peaceful heart or mind or nature into the life that we are living. We release or free all that which has been hardened, perhaps ridiculed, belittled, or constricted, not only in our lives, but really in our thinking. And in so doing, we let go of the worries and the fears and the inhibitions. When we return to the truth, we return to love, to unity, to God, spiritually expanding, evolving, and blossoming into the divine expressions of truth that we are. Yes?
Yes.
That connection to truth is like an ancient friend. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Think about it. Connection with our own truth is like connecting with an ancient friend. I invite you to sit with that in the next few days. When we come home to our heart, there is such a deep, honest familiarity as our soul yearns to be with that friend again, to the inner love that we can identify with. We may have experienced friendships in our lives that gave us such a deep sense of spiritual joining, where we were aware of coming home to our heart. Years ago, I spent time with a dear friend of mine, and we were very connected on a soul level, and our time together was extremely powerful. We shared what felt like an ancient bond, knowing that we had existed together in lifetimes before this one. The communication was always easy and seemingly unending. And those were amazing times of sharing our truth and coming home to the heart with a friend. Ancient friends can never be separated, even when one makes a transition from this earth plane. When we connect with our truth, alone or with another, and every time we remember to return to that truth, to the presence of God in our life, all is well in our soul, isn't it?
Yeah.
When we connect with the God of our understanding, when we set our mind right at the beginning of the day, our day tends to flow easier, doesn't it? Each time we do so, we make a fresh start, and we see with fresh eyes, with clarity. When we can seize the moments of each day, realizing that each day is unique and one of a kind, we can be open to the limitless amount of opportunities that guide our life in the directions that we want to go. Of course, the ideas that we hold in our mind is what directs our future. Joseph Campbell, a well-known American author, once shared, and I quote, "We must be willing to get rid of the life we've planned so as to have the life that is waiting for us. The old skin has to be shed before the new one can come." End of quote. And the same idea was echoed in Gonzalo's sharing recently, as well as those at Future Views. Have you ever noticed that if you have a pair of leather shoes that have been sitting in the closet for perhaps a couple of years, they become somewhat taut or stiff because they haven't been used or they haven't been taken care of? When we take the time to nurture ourselves, renew ourselves, re-inspire ourselves to make various changes in our lives, we can end up experiencing a sense of being flexible, right? Confident, courageous, even serene. Oprah Winfrey has been known for sharing these words, and I quote, "I want every day to be a fresh start on expanding what is possible." And then she states, and I quote, "Step out of the history that is holding you back and step into the new story that you are willing to create." End of quote. I used to play sports many, many years ago, only to realize that I wasn't being challenged enough. I had to prove to myself that I could excel in a sport where I wasn't following my brother's shadow, who himself was great in sports. So I had to create a new objective, a new vision, a fresh start for something that I could call my own. I chose to become a phenomenal badminton player. That was about 40, 45 years ago. I had developed very strong arms from other sports, and I had very, very good eye-hand coordination. So I would visualize what I had to do for my opponents never to be able to hit the birdie back to me. I did so, and I was undefeated in that sport during the time that I played. Yes. So that was also not only in class time, but also in tournament time. And I never shared that secret with anyone. There are times that we have to give ourselves permission to attempt something new, to have a fresh new outlook on how our life may show up, right? So we each are invited to close our eyes to the old endings and open our hearts to new beginnings, as we have recently been reminded of. And this is part of the new norm for many, right? When we find ways to guide our own story in new directions, we are provided with a renewed sense of freedom. And I recently heard a song by the legendary Dan Fogelberg, who sang, and I quote, "When I made my decision, my vision became my release." Isn't that powerful? Yeah. When I made my decision, my vision became my release. How are we choosing to invent ourselves every day? Will we smile more and worry less? Will we share more compassion and be less judgmental? Will we acknowledge that our lives are blessed and therefore less stressed? Will we be more loving and therefore experience less hate? It doesn't really matter where each of us has come from, does it?
No.
What matters is where we are going, what we choose to think, and how we choose to love and live in peace every day. It's crucial in these times that we're going through, perhaps even more so now, to stay prayed up, to keep our conscious contact with God, letting no one rob us of our truth. There are lyrics to a song that I wrote many years ago, which state, and I quote, "Every time we pray to God, there's the peace of a brand new day. When we listen in the silence to the still small voice, we are renewed in a special way. In these next few years, we will be tested even more, and I invite each of you to stand your ground in your truth, no matter what. Remain strong in the truth of who you are. Choose to make the rest of your life, every day, the best of your life, with the spiritual tools that you have, and wake up with a thankful heart. 2022 is a transformative year for all of us to be enjoyed more fully as we continue to be open and receptive to new truths and spiritual understandings. Be with the people that support your spiritual path. Keep the lines of communication open. Be ready to forgive where necessary. See God in everyone. When there is a feeling of emotional stumbling, reconnect with Source and reach out to your spiritual community, your spiritual family. Trust me when I say that we will need each other more in the months and the years to come. Remembering our truth will be our saving grace. There will be new beginnings, fresh starts for many. There will be more opportunities to walk the walk of love and peace. There will be many seeking for renewal and support of their faith. And each of us is being prepared daily in our own way, on our spiritual path, in order to serve as mirrors for others. Remember that. We heard that echoed, that idea being echoed in the sharing of what Inez brought forth with a reading from Marianne Williamson. Author, teacher of alternative medicine, Rachel Remen, shares these ideas, and I quote, "Perhaps the most important thing we bring to another person is the silence within us. Not the sort of silence that is filled with unspoken criticism or hard withdrawal, the sort of silence that is a place of refuge, of rest, of acceptance of someone as they are. We are all hungry for this type of silence. It is hard to find. In its presence, we can remember something beyond the moment, a strength on which to build a life. Silence is a place of great healing and power." End of quote. Sometimes in the silence of another, we feel safe enough to find a new start, a fresh start. Each one of us can have a fresh start any time that we choose to do so, and it will be a process that requires clarity, focus, direction, and gratitude. Sometimes it's just about resetting the button. And whatever took place yesterday, we are invited to release and welcome a new perspective. With each day, we can set a goal to embrace new opportunities for peace, happiness, joy, love, and abundance. And one of the bravest things that we can do in our lives is to live the life that we have been given in a way that is different from what our family and friends expect of us? Are we willing to say yes to who God has called us to be today and every day? Each time we embrace a fresh start, the new unwritten pages of our life, we are saying yes to the life and the adventure that awaits us. We are invited to rise up, to start fresh, see the bright opportunity in each day. In Psalms, we are reminded of the words, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Remember that every day. Affirm that to yourself every day. As I bring this to a close, I'd like to share a few inspiring thoughts by various authors, including such T.S. Eliot and Seneca, that speak on these powerful ideas. And I quote, "If you're brave enough to say goodbye, life will reward you with a new hello. Never underestimate the power you have to take your life in a new direction. It's continually within our power to reignite new thoughts. Begin today. Declare out loud to the universe that you are willing to let go of the struggle and eager to learn through joy." End of quote. As we all make a fresh start each day, I invite each of us to begin perhaps with setting the intention to always love, to see through the eyes of love, to share lovingly with everyone, no matter where they have come from or what their circumstances are. In this, we allow our soul to be awakened, developed, and enriched. And we invite and welcome our spiritual growth to be nurtured. Since we are all reflections of God, of Source, of love, it's up to us to remember that and to be that resemblance for others, always asking, "What would love do now in this new moment?" May 2022 be a blessed year for each of you. So be it, and so it is. Namaste. We are going to move into the tithes and offerings at this time. So we do invite you to take those tithes and gifts in your hands, bring them to your heart, bless them. And I would ask for the ushers to come forth at this time. Infinite source of all life, we give thanks for the opportunity to be blessed in these moments. We give thanks for the opportunity to share from our hearts, to make a difference in the lives of others. And we acknowledge that divine love moves in and through each and every one of us, blessing and multiplying all that we have, all that we give, and all that we receive. And so it is. Amen. Thank you. And now let us listen to Carol and the Goodfellas once again.
All right.
One. One step, one act, it's a simple fact. We can be the change. Don't have to do it all, no steps too small. We can be the change. Be the change. one simple choice.
We can be the change.
When it calls to you and it's yours to do,
we can be the change.
Be the change.
We can be the change.
Be the change.
Be the change.
Like a ripple in the ocean.
Be the change.
Oh, oh. Be the change.
We can be the change. Be the change.
Have a good day, everyone. Stay warm.